It's a physics conference, particularly focused on the role of women in physics and how we can support that. But it does that in a multiple number of ways, through workshops, through scientific talks, and through inspirational talks. I've just attended one by Dame Jocelyn Bell Burnell, who's won the Institute of Physics President's Medal. And I've just walked out of one of the most inspirational talks I think I've ever heard, talking about a person's career in science, about what motivated her throughout her career, about scientific discoveries that have changed astrophysics, and also about how she has developed as a scientist over her career, performing some of her best work now. It's actually been an inspiration to all of us attending. We've got people from all over the world in a wide variety of different career stages, countries whose scientific development is different from others, and this is an opportunity to showcase the very best science that is done worldwide.
It's a good forum for people from different countries, different cultures, to discuss their experiences and discuss also their approach on taking some action against gender imbalance and inequality. Usually in daily work as a physicist, you concentrate on the physics and not that much on gender aspects. So here you have the forum for it.
You can always talk about how we want an equal society, but to get there first, we need to have a slight push on one side to bring the women into equilibrium with the men. And I think events like this really help women back themselves in their talents and their aspirations, because you meet so many inspiring people and get to talk to so many people that are of a similar mindset to you.
We would like to support the aspirations of the whole of society. One of the great things about supporting women in physics, as with any group in physics, is we're looking for the world's best. And if you were going to exclude 50% of the people in the world from what you were doing, then you're missing out on the world's best.